Let's get this sorted. No. Let's get sorted. No. Let's get it all sorted. Let's get sorted three. So this is an application that has recently come out that I was recommended multiple times in the comment section. And it does this thing called hyperscheduling, which is unique. It's a daily planner application that apparently is fun to use and evidently is only for Mac or iOS. Time to get the phone. Because for some of us, we don't have Macs. And I really like the way this app looks, so I want to try it. When you log into Sorted, it's going to ask you whether you want to allow notifications and to give yourself calendar access. I personally don't like it. You can turn on iCloud Sync so it can go across your different devices since it is a Mac-only product. And it's going to ask you what theme you want. So I want to just go system theme, dark mode. And evidently, it's free forever. And you can enjoy the standard features of the app forever, but Pro Plan is going to be for $24.99. And that includes auto scheduling, reorganizing, duplication, iCloud sync, auto backup, and alternative app icons, as well as a passcode. So if we go into this, I'm going to start using Sorted, and it's going to spit out a list of tutorial tasks for me. It's a very nice layout, and things can be easily dragged up and down from each other. The top right, you can see that you can choose between different views. So you can have a timeline view. So that's actually really convenient for calendar sort of vibes. Filter by list, filter by tag. You can auto schedule things into different sections of the day. And you can put buffer times, put like a 5-minute buffer time between tasks, assume duration of 15 minutes, and it's gonna auto schedule. Oh, wow, I really like that. So it's gonna allow me to see, if I go to the timeline view, all the different things section like that, okay? So then if I go to the bottom right, press settings, go to calendar, turn it on. I'd like to access your calendar. So it's gonna take your calendar from your phone. So I'm gonna only select the ones that I want. So I'm gonna do my example calendar for video here. You can set the default one. And then if I press done here, you see that it has my phone associated here. So it actually understood that when I put on my calendar, wake up, that is a task. It put prepare for bed as a task and in bed as a task, which is very intriguing that it figured that out. So we had a timeline. You see that it put those in there. So if we go back here, it'll bring everything in and you're allowed to basically do a hyper. You can check the timeline here and say you had a different time block scenario where it all wasn't broken out like this. You could add things into there. And then if you want to look at the lists, you can see that you can add things to different lists. So you could quickly in the bottom right, add a new item or a new list or a new folder. So let's add a new folder actually, example folder, and you could bulk move these different guys into the folders. As you can see, I can take this guy, hide the different details if I wanted in this list. Then if I wanted to take this tutorial task here and read the actual contents of it, I could. Instead of having it all cluttered, I can just have it look like that. And the same goes for the schedule view as well. You can look at the different tasks that you have and the different things you have for your Google Calendar or whatever calendar it's synced with. I can look at it. And then in the inbox, you're able to just quickly add new tasks. So take out the trash and you can make it a new event or a new task and connect it to specific calendars. You can set to busy or free and you can add different tags. So let's say this is delegated because I don't want to take out the trash. And then let's say it's just in here. So then when I'm done, it'll be right here. And once again, you can show history or you can go back, slide to the left, press inbox. You can show the details or hide the details. You could sort this by time. And there's a lot of little helpful guides in here, which are convenient for those people who are new to the auto scheduling features. And then when you're in the schedule view, you can choose between, once again, the timeline, and you can cycle through different times by going in the bottom here and doing this and checking different dates. You can also change the spacing of things. So if you want to make it less cluttered, you can just do large. Then you'll see when I go here, it's a little less congested. And in my inbox, if I added a task for tomorrow, you'll see there's a little natural language processing there. If I press that, it'll drop it right into that date. Okay, and then like we saw earlier, you can sort it by duration or by time. So we did it by time. So then the first thing comes first. Well, I can manually do it. If I do this, it'll resort it by time. Then the search functionality of this is pretty decent. Example task here. It doesn't really look like it's letting me get anything. So, let's actually type in the right thing. Added. Yep. Added task four right there. So it can do some basic search features, which is solid. And you can actually edit different things like your recurring tasks here or your recurring calendars. You can change the recurrences within this application itself. So it can do the majority of things you want out of a daily planner app. This seems like something I would be okay with using on the go. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. And let me know what you think about this video and how to improve your productivity even more.